Roberto De Vecchi, Product Development Manager at VGrade, and today I would like to welcome you to our simulation center in Udine, that is where we develop our driving simulator technology. This is DIMU 150, our motion platform-based driving simulator that today will help us doing ADAS testing.
My name is Mark Westaway, and I'm responsible for the operation and development of the driving simulators here at VGrade, specifically focused on ADAS applications.
Hi, I'm Ram Mirwani from Konrad Technologies, and I focus on ADAS test. Konrad Technologies is a global supplier for automated test equipment for over 25 years. And today we are going to show the extension of sensor fusion HIL to include driver-in-the-loop simulation. So with driver-in-the-loop, including sensor fusion, you're going to have another level of capability to test ADAS functionality, which is now going to be possible. You will be able to have safer systems. You would be able to verify testing of ADAS capability to a new level. And you're also going to be able to do regression analysis and fault analysis in a lab environment.
Our system is able to provide the driver with all of the feedback that they would expect to experience in reality. This is including visual, audio, vibration, and motion.
A driving simulator is not just hardware, but a lot of software is required to make it work. Our VDriveSim solution is what makes our system a complete environment and also grants possibility to hook up third-party technology like traffic models or hardware sensors.
So the radar simulator from Konrad Technologies is built on the National Instruments Vehicle Radar Test System platform. It is designed for testing with object simulation and RF measurements for automotive sensors from 76 gigahertz to 81 gigahertz. For the radar simulator, on the right-hand side of the screen, we are showing the data that we get from the driving simulator software. And on the left-hand side of the screen, we are showing the data that is sent out from the sensor after we have simulated the object.
The camera test rig has been set up to replicate having a camera on the real car. The camera is stimulated by the image on the screen, and then the NVIDIA AI processes this image and displays the information of the lane markings. And finally, this information is sent to the ADAS controllers to control the vehicle. This demo has been designed to allow the human driver to experience and the engineers to test and develop their ADAS systems. This is including emergency braking, adaptive cruise control, lane keeping assist, lane departure warning, autopilot, and blind spot detection.
So driver-in-the-loop with sensor fusion test allows a different level of benefit and capability for ADAS testing. You are able to now perform stress testing and regression analysis with specific use cases to evaluate the performance of the ADAS algorithm and the ADAS capability within a lab environment, so you're in control. It is also going to allow you to have a much better conceived ADAS functionality before you go out into the drive test. So that's very important. Also, the combination of the different sensors working together with the driver perception and the driver interaction is going to be another level of testing that can be done in the lab before going out to the drive test.
The driving simulator is the perfect place where different company departments handling ride, ADAS, and powertrains meet together, assembling their own solution and making the vehicle fully functional, including human.
In partnering with VGrade and the experience that they bring in from the simulation world, Konrad Technologies is now able to extend sensor fusion HIL to also include the simulation piece before going out into the drive test, and that's definitely something that we are very excited to work with VGrade on.